Hi, and welcome to Ask Swagelok. I'm Beth Neeser, and I'm here with Buddy Damm, who's a senior scientist of metallurgy here at Swagelok. So, Buddy, you've been telling us a little bit about corrosion in offshore oil and gas applications, and you also mentioned internally influenced and externally influenced corrosion. Can you explain some of the different types of externally influenced corrosion and some of the mitigations for it?
Yeah, so one common type of externally influenced corrosion is uniform corrosion. And so, as the name implies, you're uniformly corroding something, consuming the material. And so mitigation for this is to potentially just use a thick component so that during the corrosion process, over the life of the component, you still are functional at the end.
Okay.
You can also paint the component, or you may choose a more corrosion-resistant alloy. Another type of common corrosion in offshore is galvanic corrosion. And this happens when you take two dissimilar metals and you connect them, like say a bolt holding a plate together, for example. Mm-hmm. If one material is more susceptible to corrosion than the other, when you couple them that way, you'll actually accelerate the corrosion in the more susceptible material. Hmm. So to mitigate this, you want to make good choices on material selection and avoid galvanic coupling that's too strong. And then the next type of corrosion is locally influenced corrosion. And there's two types. There's pitting corrosion and crevice corrosion. And the reason locally influenced corrosion or local corrosion occurs is because of something called a passive oxide film that forms on most metals. And it provides a level of protection against corrosive environments. That corrosion resistant oxide layer is enhanced by the chrome content in stainless steel. So using a higher chrome steel results in a more robust passive oxide film and better resistance to pitting and crevice corrosion. Another type of corrosion that's common is chloride stress corrosion cracking. If you have a component that's under stress and exposed to a chloride-rich environment or a dissolved salt in seawater, the combination of the stress and the chloride will attack the material and cause cracking. The mitigation for this is to increase the nickel content in the material. So for both of those, for localized corrosion and chloride stress corrosion cracking, Swagelok specifies our material to have enhanced chemistries. So the ASTM standard requirement for chrome is 16 to 18 weight percent chrome. Swagelok specifies a minimum 17. ASTM standard for nickel is 10 to 14. Swagelok specifies a minimum of 12%. And then we also offer a range of other alloys with higher chrome and moly and nitrogen and nickel. All of these things enhance corrosion resistance. Then there are a couple of other important things that also happen on offshore. One of them is fretting corrosion. And this happens when you have two sliding components next to each other, like two tubes. The combination of wear and corrosion happening together creates fretting. And so designing tubing runs so that that contact doesn't happen and properly supporting the tube at regular intervals is important. And then you can get fatigue problems on an offshore rig. So things that are cyclically loaded will accumulate fatigue damage. And if that happens in a corrosive environment, that fatigue damage will accelerate. So for example, if you have a tube run coming out of a compressor, supporting that tube at regular intervals will reduce the vibration and the cyclic loading on it and improve resistance fatigue.
So it sounds like one of the key takeaways here is that adding certain elements to stainless alloys can help mitigate some of the types of corrosion.
Yeah, so for local corrosion, increasing the chrome, molybdenum, and nitrogen content increases the resistance of that passive oxide layer and helps you avoid pitting and crevice corrosion.
Okay.
In chloride stress corrosion cracking, increasing the nickel content of this steel improves the resistance to that. And you can go all the way up to a nickel-based alloy, which is effectively immune to chloride stress corrosion cracking. And there's also another solution in that you can use duplex stainless steels. So duplex stainless steels have a relatively low amount of nickel, but an increased amount of chrome, and that results in a duplex microstructure of ferrite and austenite together. And that alloy also has excellent resistance to chloride stress corrosion cracking.
Okay, great. Well, thank you for that information. And thank you all for joining us for Ask Swagelok.